Interim World Championship of Wrestling, and that giant is none other than the one-man gang!
No!
He's a giant!
Chicago, right here on Channel 9, Tony Schiavone and the legend himself, Larry Zbyszko. An exciting program this week. As you know, we're 1 week away from World Championship Wrestling's big return right here to the UIC Pavilion. But this week on the program, Larry Z will be talking to Ron Simmons.
You know, I think we remember a couple of weeks ago when Ron Simmons ran out into the ring, throwing Harbor his former partner, Butch Reed, proving the type of man Ron Simmons is. So anything can go in Larry Z's Legends this week.
This week on the program, also another Super Brawl update as we head toward the big event exclusively on pay-per-view on May 19th.
And I tell you, you people think the Los Angeles Police Department is brutal. This is the pay-per-view you don't miss.
Fans, we have an exciting program, including a look at what's been going on between the Total Package Lex Luger and the Russian Nightmare Nikita Koloff. And right now, let's go to our first event this week on WGN.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following event is set to unfold. Introducing first team number one, weighing on the combined weight of 670 pounds from Argentina, Elegante, and his partner from Cincinnati, Ohio, Malias Bryant. In the ring, their opponents, first from New York City, Duke Fine, and from Albuquerque, New Mexico, Mark Kyle.
All right, we start out with a great tag team event here on the Pro. There he is, all 7 foot, 7 inches of him, El Gigante. He and Flying Brian together set to go right here this Saturday morning on Channel 9.
Well, you know something, Tony, Flying Brian's a very fast individual, but I'm amazed, frankly, on El Gigante, because he can move. I mean, you watch him out there, oh!
Drop kick out of the middle, turnbuckle, sending now. Doug Bynes down, Flying Brian. When we think about courage, determination, and guts, we first think of him. Here's a double team. He's underneath. Tremendous move over the far ropes that time. And a double drop kick sending both men down. And you are ready for a big tag.
Uh-oh.
Now he got down the clothesline on Kyle. The big foot on Vines. Look out. A literal tower of strength right now.
I think the man died from fright.
Going out on Kyle now, right to a wrist lock. Fans, as you know, we're going to be talking about our big card coming up next week at the UIC Pavilion. In addition, coming up next, some more matches to be announced for Super Brawl, exclusively on pay-per-view. Dropkick from Flying Brian. Elegante on the outside. Flying Brian on top. Here he goes.
Flying He's got him. Press. He's got him.
You got tremendous athletes like that, they can certainly dominate a match, and that's exactly what happened here, Larry.
Yeah, well, Tony, it certainly helps when you got a man 7'9" or 8', whatever. But Flying Brian right here showed his ability. Boom, hit the momentum. Now watch here how he hooks the leg, bringing the weight upon the shoulder. That's what enabled him to get the three count, is hooking that leg 1, 2, 3. And like again, of course, his partner isn't exactly like no help.
Fans, let's take you now to the Super Brawl Control Center with Gordon Solik.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gordon Solik, and welcome once again to the Super Brawl Control Central. As we told you last week, some great matches have already been signed. Let me recap them right now. First of all, the U.S. Tag Team Championship goes up for grabs. The Young Pistols facing the Fabulous Freebirds. In a World Television Championship match, it will be Arn Anderson defending that title against Beautiful Bobby. Ricky Morton goes up against Dangerous Dan Spivey, and Big Josh takes on the living legend Larry Zbyszko. Now, two more matches have been signed in a stretcher match. The only way you can win is your opponent must be carried out on a stretcher. It will be the 7 foot, 7 inch, El Gigante, the Argentinian giant, taking on 6'9" Sid Vicious. In addition to this, the World Tag Team Championship goes on the line. The Steiners defending against Lex Luger and Sting. Let's hear from both tag teams right now.
Super Brawl premier matchup. Steiners, the Stinger, and myself. Friendship aside, it'll be wide open.
I know what it's like to wrestle against somebody you just can't stand. Well, I kind of like the Steiners, but I'm looking forward to getting in the ring with those guys.
Sting and Lex, don't make a big mistake. We may travel together, but when we get in the ring, we ain't going to be partners, we ain't going to be buddies, and we ain't going to be friends. Me and my brother, one thing to do, and that's beat you up.
Brother, what a match that's going to be. The World Tag Team Championship on the line. The Steiners against Lex Luger and Sting. Now you ask, how can I become a part of this? That's simple. Merely pick up the phone right now. Call your local cable operator and order Super Brawl 91. It's all coming your way, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Sunday, May 19th. And I'll be back next week with the biggest news yet.
Rolling Thunder Tour 91, Hammond, Indiana, Friday, April 26th, 8 o'clock at the Civic Center. And Rolling Thunder Tour 91 returns to UIC Pavilion, Chicago, Sunday, April 28th, 7:30. A super night, 8 exciting matches, including the main event in a cage, Sting and El Gigante clash with Ric Flair and Barry Windham. In a computer match, Beautiful Bobby takes on Terrence Taylor. World Tag Team titles on the line in Chicago. The Steiners against Stan Hansen and Sid Vicious. The U.S. title on the line at UIC Pavilion. Lex Luger clashing with Nikita Koloff. Grudge match, Ron Simmons against his former partner. Quick Reed, main event in a cage. Sting and El Gigante take on Ric Flair and Barry Windham. Plus Big Van Vader, Big Josh, The Natural, Dustin Rhodes, and more. Sunday the 28th, 7:30. Tickets at the Pavilion box office at all Ticketron outlets, including Sears. Yes, Rolling Thunder Tour 91, the 28th, Chicago.
That the giant in a cage?
You will be in Chicago, as a matter of fact, in a big event against Big Van Vader. Wow.
Yeah, well, I think what I'm going to do is expose Van Vader's face to everybody in the Windy City. I'm going to rip that mask off, and we're going to see how ugly this man really is. I hear he is extremely ugly.
Arn Anderson, very cautious against Tim Horner. Of course, white lightning Tim Horner is a superb athlete from Morristown, Tennessee. Takes Arn Anderson down with the wrist lock and then goes right to the arm, and the World TV champion, who is a master at controlling the tempo of a match, gets right up and out of the way again.
You know, Arn Anderson getting a little frustrated there because Tim Horner is a very good technical wrestler. He's a ring veteran, and of course, you know, Anderson's a very tough man. This will be a very interesting match to watch, you know, especially from my viewpoint, because I appreciate good scientific wrestling.
Anderson out of the way with a knee.
That's it.
Some tremendous announcements as Arn Anderson works on Tim Horner in the corner. This week from our Super Brawl Control Center as they send Horner in. He slipped underneath.
You know, Anderson thought he threw him into the corner.
He missed a left hand, and Horner comes in with a drop kick. And again, Anderson with a wild left hand, a pickup.
Ow!
Anderson in the turnbuckle.
He's got him up.
Two counts. And Anderson on the outside. Quickly.
Smart move by Anderson here. Stop that momentum as Horner caught him off guard.
What about our announcements? The stretcher match. Sid Vicious against Elegante. Loser must be carried out on the stretcher. And what about for the World Tag Title? Sting and Lex Luger together announced this week against Rick and Scott Steiner for the World Tag Team Title. Friend against friend.
Yeah, now that is going to be an emotional one because, you know, that line between friendship and big money and world championships is two different things, Shivani. Believe me, I've been stabbed in the back by men that claim to be my friends a lot over the years.
That is exclusively on pay-per-view as part of Super Brawl. And some more big announcements coming up. As Gordon said, the biggest announcement next week yet to come.
Yeah, Arn Anderson didn't look up on time. Oh, he got himself out of that one. Horner had him.
Anderson comes on with a sleeper now. Maybe shocking white lightning Tim Horner, but Horner shoots him in. And he puts a sleeper out of his own.
Well, we'll see if he has this one hooked any more than Anderson did. No, he didn't.
Oh. Belly to back suplex, but Horner continues to hold on. But Horner's shoulders are down. And you can see the pain on the face of Tim Horner. Great execution.
Yeah. Hey, to get the wind knocked out of you like that and maintain the headlock and keep that hold on.
Bill Alfonso, the official assigned to this match. This is for the World TV title. Over the top, Tim Horner. Right to the midsection.
Boy, Horner ran into that one.
Arn Anderson has announced last week will be defending the World Television belt at Super Brawl against Vito Bobby. That is, of course, if he continues to hold on to the belt after this match right here. A stomp to the midsection, and Arn Anderson takes the laces now to the eyes of Tim Horner.
You know, it looks like Arn Anderson is going to make sure that he does keep the title, Tony, and Tim Horner is a man capable of taking it at any second. That's why I think Anderson is using, you know, right down and dirty tactics right here, just like this. He's not going to give Horner the opportunity at all.
Horner on the outside. Fans, want to remind you of Sunday, April 28th. That's next Sunday at 7:30 is our Rolling Thunder Tour. Stops right here in Chicago. Tickets at the Pavilion box office and all Ticketron outlets, including Sears in the Chicagoland area. Right now, Tim Horner in trouble. Arn Anderson shoots a knee right to the back, and Horner is really in trouble down on the apron now. Arn Anderson not allowing to get in, but Horner,
he's going for it.
Over the top. Anderson completely confused.
He got him in a backslide. Oh, almost had him.
Arn Anderson ducked out a potential sunset flip, and with the backslide, Horner almost had a three count. Sending Anderson in. An elbow. Tim Horner, who has been a tag team champion in the past, but never a singles champion in World Championship Wrestling, looking for his first title and a cover. Right hand to the face.
And Horner's got to stay aggressive. He's got to stay on the man now, now.
Horner looking back now. Got Anderson.
Oh.
Head first to the turnbuckle. Neutral corner, near side.
Oh, Horner's getting serious here, Shivani.
You're right over the action. As close as you can be. The champion's head ran to all three turnbuckles, top to bottom. Oh! Incredible move! And he wins it!
He was the winner and still World Television Champion, Arn Anderson!
This is our Castro replay, and it was a tremendous move by the champion to retain the title from Tim Horner. Wow, what a match and what a move, Larry.
You know, Tony, right here, I tell you, Tim Horner at the end of this match, not here, going over. You know, he gave Arn Anderson, really had Arn Anderson confused a few times. And Anderson had to resort to those down and dirty catches. But boy, at the very end, Tim Horner thought he had him. Right here, Arn Anderson caught him out of the blue. That's why this man is the champion, because he can catch you when you least expect it, and Horner didn't expect that. Unbelievable.
Castro, engineer for today's Monica.
Inside, your smooth-running engine is a torture chamber. And under these grueling conditions, only one leading motor oil meets the world's toughest requirements for viscosity breakdown. Castrol. The only leading motor oil that provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. So use Castrol. After all, why make things tougher on your engine? Castrol GTX. Engineered for today's smaller cars.
Attention, wrestling fans!
Get your credit card ready to order the hottest collection of wrestling videos we've ever offered!
First, it's non-stop headbanging, body-slamming action
with the All-American Champion, Hulk Hogan!
See Hulk team up with Andre the Giant as never before!
Then it's blow after blow from the viciously brutal Sergeant Slaughter!
Plus, you'll also get Hawk and Animal!
The Road Warriors, the most devastating tag team champions of a decade!
This complete set of exclusive videos is jam-packed with the ultimate in high-flying,
bone-crushing,
pro wrestling excitement!
And if you order now, we'll also include a digital sports watch absolutely free.
This offer not available in stores.
So get your credit card and order TV's hottest wrestling videos for the incredibly low price of just $29.90 and get the watch free.
Remember, you get a set of three exciting videos, 90 minutes of action, but you must call now.
Don't miss this exciting offer. Get your credit card and call 1-800-292-6500 to get TV's greatest wrestling videos for $29.90 plus shipping and handling. That's three videos, 90 minutes of action. 1-800-292-6500. Call now.
From Wyoming and a combined weight of 489 pounds, Chrissy and C, the York Pistol! Entering now from across from Hollywood, Florida, Dave Johnson! And from New York City, Lou Fabiano!
All right, two young men who will be going after the U.S. tag belts at Super Brawl. And they had these comments to tell us earlier today.
Three birds, we don't care if you got King Kong, Godzilla in your corner, because May 19th, Super Brawl, we're going to be the new United States Tag Team Champions.
That's right. We got one goal in mind, and Fat Daddy Stink and Diamond Dork Page, if you think you're going to get involved, you got another thing coming, young pistol.
It'll be quite a battle, as announced last week at Gordon Solie's Super Brawl Control Center. Young Pistols, Free Birds for that vacated U.S. Tag Team title at Super Brawl.
Oh, yeah, and again, you know, the Young Pistol here, they're dying to beat the Freebird. That's going to give them the reputation that they're looking for in, you know, WCW.
Over the top.
Oh, he does some good teamwork here.
Fabiano held on nicely, but now a double team here. Tracy and Steve both in. Double shoulder, sending Lou Fabiano down. And now both men going right after Dave Johnson. Hit him in. Double shoulder on Johnson. It's going to be teamwork like this that's going to propel them possibly to those U.S. tag team belts.
You know, don't sit back and think that these guys aren't in there training every day, because you've got to work out with your partner at least 2-3 hours a day, Tony, to get that teamwork down. I mean, you practically have to, you know, live together to get that type of teamwork needed to win championships.
Collar and elbow tie after the side headlock. There's Steve from behind with a good reversal to a hammerlock, and here comes Tracy back in. All right, the Pistols looking crisp, sharp, and as good as ever. Fans want to remind you, one of the great matches you are going to see here in Chicago next weekend is going to be a grudge match, Ron Simmons against Butch Reed. And, of course, Ron Simmons coming up a little bit later on with you, Larry Zbysko.
Well, Larry, these legends are going to bring Ron Simmons out if he can control himself this time. Last time I was interviewing Butch Reed, out came Simmons, you know, with a very, very bad attitude problem. We'll see if he can calm down and find out his side to this whole feud.
If anyone knows anything about attitudes, it's you, Larry. Right to the arm now.
That's why they call me a legend, Shabani.
Tracy, now against the Freebirds, let's size up the two teams briefly if we can. You know, the Freebirds have Big Daddy Dink, Diamond Dallas Page. They'll pull out all the stops, as the old cliche goes.
They will.
But the Pistols will have to do much the same. They'll have to be, as you say, aggressive, just like the Freebirds.
What the Pistols are going to have to do is try to block out Big Daddy Dink and Diamond Dallas Page, if possible. We know they're going to be there.
They're going to have to concentrate on their teamwork, and they're going to have to catch the Freebirds off guard. And I think they're going to have to catch them off guard early, like within the first 10 minutes. Otherwise, that psychology of Big Daddy Dink and Diamonds Dallas Page will do in the young pistol.
Fabiano down, and he trips up and holds the leg of Tracy that time. And that gives Johnson the opportunity to take some advantage here. Here's a double team from Johnson and Fabiano. But no, Tracy one step ahead. Great anticipation right there.
He saw it coming.
Yeah, and here comes Steve in now. And he's going to take on both men. Tremendous drive kick.
That referee was on the ball. He'd be getting one of these guys out of here.
Double team here. Double flying elbow that time. Ready to put him up top. And the Young Pistols with a tremendous win streak in World Championship Wrestling. Looking to be the next U.S. Tag Team Champion.
Boy, he's way out there.
Look at him. Here he goes.
Oh.
Tremendous. We got a cover and we got a three count.
The winners of the Not So Young.
It'll be quite a battle. Freebirds Pistols for the U.S. title at Super Brawl. Back with more on Channel 9 after this.
You know, it's come to my attention lately that one of the announcers in this wrestling group we have around here by the name of Larry Zbyszko has been having a little fun with old Brickhouse. Now, I've worked with all the fellas we have up till now, fellas like Tony Schiavone and Jimmy Ross and Gordon Solie and Lance Russell, solid, seasoned, experienced professionals for whom I have a great respect. So I thought I'd check Larry out a little bit. I found out that he did have a fairly good reputation as a wrestler himself. But as a broadcaster, this guy's been at it less than 4 months. That's interesting. You know, I've often wondered, I've said this many times, I'd like to finish my career as a cover man, so I got anywhere from 30 seconds to 2 hours to figure out what I'm going to say next. Larry, I'm in 9 halls of fame. How are you doing these days? This is Jack Brickhouse with another Brickhouse bonus.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following six-man tag team event is set for one fall. Introducing first team number one. They win in a combined weight of 761 pounds. They are the six-man world tag team champions. First from North Carolina, the Junkyard Dog. His partner from Atlanta, Georgia, World Fire, Tommy Rich. And from Nashville, Tennessee, Ricky Morton. In the ring, their opponents. First, Rip Rogers from Seymour, Indiana. Don Allen from Tampa, Florida.
Next event on Channel 9. So the six-man tag team champions of the world against three competitors who I'm not so sure are in their class, but they are fine athletes nonetheless. Now Rip from Seymour, Indiana. Speaking of Indiana fans, Larry Zbyszko now has left the broadcast location, and he is making his way down now towards the ring area. He will be hosting Larry Z's Legends coming up next. However, we want to talk to our great fans in the Hammond, Indiana area, not too far away from right here in Chicago, over in Hammond, Indiana. That World Championship Wrestling will be returning now in less than a week. This coming Friday, April 26th, 8 o'clock at the Hammond Civic Center. Here's a great arm drag for more. We have a great card. Our promoter, Don Glass, over in Hammond, doing a tremendous job, and we invite all of our fans in the Hammond, the Gary, even over in South Bend in the Elkhart area, to come and see World Championship Wrestling. I mean, we have all the top stars coming to Hammond, to the midsection. Double axe handle from Wildfire Tommy Rich. Now, on the card in Hammond, you're going to see live and in person at the Civic Center as a dog comes in. Such stars as Big Van Vader, the natural Dustin Rhodes, Big Josh will be there. Look at that big suit bone. Watch out, all fours in a headbutt. Flying Brian's gonna be there. Lex Luger, Nikita Koloff, the Steiner brothers, Arn Anderson, yes, Larry Zbyszko will be there. Ron Simmons, Butch Reed, Sting, El Gigante, Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and Barry Windham. Tickets now on sale at the Hammond Civic Center box office, and I had a chance to be in Hammond Many years ago, they have some of the greatest World Championship Wrestling fans in the entire world. We look forward to coming back this coming Friday, the 26th of April, 8 o'clock. Here's a tag, and Ricky Morton in. Double team right on the chest. I'm going to give you an information phone number, too, from Hammond. This is for information. Area code 219-853-6378. 219-853-6378 for information about the big card coming to the Hammond Civic Center of World Championship Wrestling Friday, April 26th, 8 o'clock bell time. Morton now, and Rich cheering on the dog, the six-man champ. Dog looking around. Right down the back of the neck that time, and all the weight of the JYD. Tommy Rich in. Well, I should say that it's kind of relaxed up here, and as Yokozuna comes in, and different without Larry Zbyszko. Larry will be with us, of course, after his Larry Z's Legends concludes at the beginning of the next break, or the next segment after the break. Kozuna missed the elbow. Ricky Morton. One, two. And Rip Rogers walks right into that one. We got all six in. Our fans in Hammond, it'll be action like this. You'll see live at the Civic Center this Friday, April 26th, 8 o'clock. Pick up! Big thump! Zbyszko will be set to do his Larry Z's Legends coming up right after the break, and then he'll be back with us here at the broadcast location. But right now, double team that time, double clothesline. And then, of course, the dog won it with a big thump on Joe Cassetta. Fans, don't forget, Friday, April 26th, 8 o'clock at Hammond, the Civic Center. Tickets now on sale at the Civic Center box office. It'll be next Friday. So we look forward to seeing all our great fans coming to Hammond, as well as the UIC Pavilion coming up on Sunday the 28th. Larry Z will be back with us with Larry Z's Legends when the pro returns on Channel 9.
Introducing the new Wrestling Hotline.
Tony Schiavone.
Matt Watts with Steve Beverly.
Paul E. Dangerously.
Straight Up with Sting.
Lex Luger.
The Jim Ross Report.
Missy Hyatt.
1-900-909-9900. The Wrestling Hotline. Your main line to the stars. $2 first minute, 45 cents each additional minute. Kids 18 and under obtain your parents' permission before calling. 1-900-909-9900.
Dial it. The talking is done.
The time to act is now. Bring the action of World Championship Wrestling right to your door by subscribing to the Wrestling Wrap-Up. Act now and get a year subscription to wrestling's most informative news monthly for just $24.95. That's more than 50% off the cover price. The Wrestling Wrap-Up is not available in stores, so subscribe now by calling 404-827-4048 to charge by Visa or MasterCard, or send your check or money order to the Wrestling Wrap-Up.
You know, this week on Larry Z's Legends, if the man can control himself, we're going to get his side of the story. And I'm talking about an all-American Florida Seminole, Ron Simmons.
Now you can see him standing because he is making his way to the ring. And it's a big grudge match 1 week away against Hacksaw Butch Reed, his former partner right here in Chicago. Tremendous athlete. Let's go back to Larry Z.
You know, I tried to conduct an interview with Butch Reed, and out you came. Now, I hope we can control ourselves, because I got a question. We all know how you feel about Teddy Long and Butch Reed. Now, what I want to ask you is, we've got all of a sudden Kevin Sullivan and the one-man gang that you should be concentrating on, I think. What do you think about the one-man gang and Kevin Sullivan?
First of all, let me tell you this. You don't know how I feel because you wasn't the one at the end of that belt. And another thing is this. No, you wait a minute.
Hey, wait a minute. I know how you feel about getting stabbed. No. Go ahead. Tell him how you... Go ahead.
My gripe is not with One Man Gang and Kevin Sullivan, but if they want to get in the way of what Ron Simmons is doing, be my guest. Now let me tell you this. Teddy Long, if you're hiding Butch Reed anywhere in this world, the last thing Ron Simmons will do is find him and let him know that he's met his match and it's going to be his last match when I get my hands on him.
You know what? Still, you're dwelling on the, you know, Butch Reed. I'm talking about Kevin Sullivan, One Man Gang. One Man Gang is twice your size. Don't you think maybe it's kind of stupid to take him so light?
A tree is 5 million times the size of an axe, but it will fall, won't it? And that's what's going to happen if he gets in my way. And if Butch Reed is in this building tonight, come on out, Ron Simmons. We'll show you what a pair of natives.
No, don't come out now. Don't come out now. I'm talking about Kevin Sullivan, One Man Gang. What are you going to do about him? I mean, don't avoid the question. Be a man. What are you going to do about them?
Didn't I just get through telling you that I didn't have a gripe with Kevin Sullivan and One Man Gang? And if they want a part of Ron Simmons, all they've got to do is track me down. I am not hard to find.
Well, do it your way. Back.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is simple, one call. Introducing first from Sweetwater, Texas, at 280 pounds, Barry Windham. And his opponent from Rock City, Florida, 243 pounds, Scott Allen.
All right, Barry Windham set to go against Scott Allen. This event here on the Pro.
You think one time you can do an interview without being a little bit belligerent?
Well, I'm just trying to, you know, get out of the man. I asked him about Kevin Sullivan. I asked him about One Man Gang.
And he told you about
him,
Barry.
Well, he sidesteps me, Shivani.
Here's a guy who won't sidestep anybody, Barry Windham, who had some comments earlier on.
The city of Chicago is going to see a lot of changes in 91, and I'm going to be a part of them. The goals that I set will be attained easily, and Chicago is going to be there to witness it firsthand every time I appear there.
Barry Windham and Ric Flair together 1 week away now, next Sunday night, the 28th, against Sting and 7'7" Elegante, and they're going to put him in a cage right here in Chicago.
But the Elegante is one man that you would not want to be locked in a cage with, and that is one fact for sure.
Well, I would agree with that. However,
now, I agree with this. I'm trying to help Ron Simmons out by maybe giving him some advice about paying more attention to One Man Gang and Kevin Sullivan. He looks to me like I'm some kind of an idiot. Well, do it his way. He made it real big so far.
You dang on right he has. In amateur as well as professional sports. Pick up the superplex from Barry Windham. Barry Windham gets a win.
Here's your winner, Barry Windham.
And we're going to take a look once again. Maybe the superplex, the best move in world championship.
Barry Windham is 100% wrestling class. And here's an example of it right here. Boom. Picks him up. Top row. Bang. You can beat Barry Windham, you've beaten one of the best in the business.
He's the winner. And he'll be the main event 1 week away. When we come back, a close look at a very controversial situation with Nikita Koloff and Lex Luger.
Bring new power to your telephone. The Wrestling Fun Line. Call 1-900-288-4FUN. Test your knowledge in the wrestling trivia game. Leave a personal message for your favorite star. Listen in on other fan comments and questions. Hear the stars answer. Or voice your opinion on the hot wrestling topics of the day. All this on the Wrestling Fun Line. 1-900-288-4FUN. $1.95 per minute or part thereof.
The greatest wrestling in the world is World Championship Wrestling. And now you can support your favorite World Championship Wrestling superstar with exciting gifts and souvenirs from WCW Merchandise. To receive your free World Championship Wrestling gift catalog, write WCW Merchandise, Post Office Box 105716, Atlanta, Georgia, 30348-5716. Or call area code 404-853-4607. Okay, fans, back with you on the Pro here in Chicago. We have a lot of hot issues in World Championship Wrestling as we head into Super Brawl. But none as hot as the one between the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff, and the U.S. champion, Lex Luger.
And these two men will meet one-on-one next weekend right here in Chicago at the UIC Pavilion. The situation all began back on February 24th in Phoenix. I was standing close by when Nikita Koloff presented Lex Luger the U.S. heavyweight belt.
I just want to say that it was a pleasure watching that match. I congratulate you on a great victory. I've got something here for you, Lexler. I know you've been waiting for this. I take a lot of pride and a great pleasure in giving this to you.
Oh, good grief! What's he doing? The Russian Nightmare Nikita Koloff certainly made a big statement right to the Total Package Lex Luger. And then when Jim Ross on a nationwide program was interviewing the Total Package Lex Luger, Nikita Koloff had something to say, and this erupted.
From the long-awaited confrontation with you and the Russian Nightmare Nikita Koloff for the United States heavyweight
Luger!
Title.
Luger!
You know, Jim Ross.
Hey, Luger!
He's good at biting heads off dolls.
Luger! Come on, baby, let's see what you're made of.
Well, Nikita Koloff up on our interview area.
Show me what you're made of.
Lex Luger is going there now, ladies and gentlemen. Luger and Koloff really kicking it. Luger and Koloff having a brawl there. There are the Steiners and many others in the locker room trying to separate. These two men cannot wait until that match is signed for the United States Heavyweight Championship. Oh, what a fist fight! What a battle out in the crowd!
From there, the situation intensified. Lex Luger came to the ring when Jim Ross was talking to the Russian Nightmare Nikita Koloff, and then it all erupted in the ring. Once again, the belt up against the side of the head of the U.S. champion, Lex Luger.
I am the U.S. champion. You understand me?
I understand what you're claiming, but Lex Luger still has possession of the belt.
Oh, here we go.
And here it comes. Well, he says you want it. Here it is.
And they're going at it, and neither one is backing up on the other. Koloff and Luger going at it. Toe-to-toe in the middle of the ring, man. This is one war that needs to be settled.
Last week, it was Koloff instigating the fight. This week, it was Luger coming down. It says, you want the damn belt, then you come and get it. And what a fight we've got here now. Bodies emptying out of the locker room. Luger and Koloff, this is a war, an international war. Bodies are fighting all over the place. They're hooking it up. What a brawl, what a fight, and it's out of control here.
And now, fans, from there, we take you to the Meadowlands right outside of New York City, one-on-one. Nikita Koloff against Lex Luger, U.S. title match, and what a controversial ending to this match. Let's take a look at the footage and be back with more comments. He has the Russian sickle, the chain wrapped around the arm. Bill Alfonso still down, and Koloff trying to hide that chain. Here's the cover. Alfonso is up. Wait a second. Was that a three count or not? Koloff thinks he's the new champ. Well, apparently that's not the case. Wait a second. No, sir. Luger's going to win the match. Using the chain. You see it. Disqualification.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nikita Koloff has been disqualified. For who is the WCW United States Heavyweight Champion, the Total Package, Lex Luger.
Well, you hear the official announcement. Koloff is qualified. Luger is still the champ. But Koloff.
belligerent, despicable. No, watch out, there's Luger. From behind, double X. My goodness, they're fighting back near the dressing room, and now Luger. And Koloff coming back. Head first to the table. The match is over. Luger has won by disqualification, but the battle continues. Luger with it. Picks him up. I thought maybe a power slam. Yes, that's what it's going to be. Chain that Koloff used earlier on that got him. Koloff disqualified. And now Luger, as Koloff gets up, he nails Koloff. Referee Bill Alfonso warning Luger. Oh my goodness, he hit Bill Alfonso with the chain. He hit the referee. Luger, like a wild man, hit the referee. Yeah, there's your announcement again. He's the champion, but I can't believe he hit the referee like he did. This is absolutely wild. All right. What a confrontation. Luger and wait a minute, there's Koloff. Back in the dressing room area as our camera's going all the way back, and this fight is going on back in the dressing room. There you see many of the wrestlers, Arn Anderson, Dustin Rhodes, some of the young pistols, Owen Hart, trying to break this thing up. Truly one of the wildest situations we've ever seen involving the U.S. title.
Keep it rolling.
The battle continues here at the Metal Man. This is crazy. Fans, we do understand the World Championship Wrestling Board of Directors right now looking into that footage from the Meadowlands, and they will make some sort of verdict based on what we have just seen in the weeks to come. However, we do know the situation has started back on February 24th between Lex Luger, the Total Package, and Nikita Koloff will come to a climax in the UIC Pavilion. It'll be one-on-one, the Total Package Lex Luger against the Russian Nightmare Nikita Koloff next weekend. Back with comments from Luger after this timeout.
Rolling Thunder Tour 91, Hammond, Indiana, Friday, April 26th, 8 o'clock at the Civic Center. And Rolling Thunder Tour 91 returns to UIC Pavilion, Chicago, Sunday, April 28th, 7:30. A super night, 8 exciting matches, including the main event in a cage, Sting and Ellie Gandhi clash with Ric Flair and Barry Windham. In a computer match, Beautiful Bobby takes on Terrence Taylor. World Tag Team titles on the line in Chicago. The Steiners against Stan Hansen and Sid Vicious. The U.S. title on the line at UIC Pavilion. Lex Luger clashing with Nikita Koloff. Grudge match, Ron Simmons against his former partner, Butch Reed. Main event in a cage, Sting and Ellie Gandhi take on Ric Flair and Barry Windham, plus Big Van Vader, Big Josh, the Natural, Dustin Rhodes, and more. Sunday the 28th, 7:30. Tickets at the Pavilion box office at all Ticketron outlets, including Sears. Yes, Rolling Thunder Tour 91, the 28th, Chicago.
Now you could win a valuable Topps baseball card every time you open a pack of Topps. All right! Clemens, Strawberry, Willie Mays, even the 52 Mickey Mantle worth over $8,000. Thousands have been won, but thousands are still out there. Plus, every pack has a sweepstakes entry. Win a complete vintage card set. Or the grand prize, all 40 years of Topps. 300,000 winners in all. Collect for fun. Collect to win with Topps.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Starting your engine's a terrible thing to do because at startup, oil's in the pan, not in the engine. Startup lubrication that lasts over 50,000 miles. Slick 50, the engine wear protector.
Double Dragon 3. The greatest martial arts adventure continues with all new weapons, characters, and street fighting moves. Double Dragon 3 from Acclaim. Twice the characters, three times the action.
This is not what you want in a shave. Now you've got the edge. With six rich lubricants for less irritation, you've got the edge.
Sneaker Tamers insoles. Tame ferocious sneaker odor with the world's most powerful odor destroyer. Activated charcoal. Today's program has been brought to you in part by Castrol Motor Oil. Engineered for today's smaller cars.
Chicago Wrestling, a town that likes it rough and tough. A town that has a penchant for violence. We've got a cage match there involving Flair, the Giant, Wyndham, Sting. But if you're in the violence, there's one match you're going to watch real close, very intensely, because a lot of intensity between the two competitors. That's Nikita Koloff and myself for the U.S. title. Now we're going to see just how bad you are, Nikita, right there in Chicago.
Wrestling fans, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first from Chicago, Illinois, 283 pounds. He's the total package.
The Meadowlands between these two men, and of course, World Championship Wrestling Board of Directors, as we said, are going to be looking into this situation about the U.S. title. One thing we do know, that these two men will go one-on-one, Lex Luger and Nikita Koloff, next Sunday here in Chicago, Lex Luger's hometown.
You know what? They're both powerhouses. I mean, two powerhouse individuals, and you know, it's just basically brawn against brawn.
Shoulder block right on the side. Side headlock in the total package. Lex Luger, even though he's very strong and very powerful, Larry, Nikita Koloff is much the same. So it's going to probably come down to, you talk about a brutal match, but maybe the man who wrestles the most to win the match.
Could be the man that wrestles the most. Could be the man who has the best endurance. I mean, I'm looking, you know, for a long match. See which one wears down first. It's like Penrose went for a move and missed it. Lex Luger just thought, you dummy.
An elbow, and also the big announcement that we heard earlier on, and what an announcement it is. Luger and Sting, they wanted to be World Tag Team Champs. Power Slam! They're going to get their chance.
Good night.
Against the Steiners at Super Brawl, Sunday, May 19th, exclusively on pay-per-view. He's got Penrose up. Randy Anderson checking in. There's your bell.
The winner of the match, a total package, Lex Luger.
Luger, though, has to think first of Nikita Koloff. And it's going to be in Luger's backyard. You know, we say explosive so many times, but it really applies here.
Well, that is Lex Luger's middle name, explosive, right here. Up goes Penrose, down, boom, like a piece of paper. Luger, very strong, strong individual. We'll find out how much endurance he has when he tangles with Nikita Koloff.
Fans, next week right here on Channel 9, an exciting program. Larry Zbyszko talks to the natural Dustin Rhodes.
Well, you know, here we go. You know, you and me keep talking about Dustin Rhodes. The test of time. Will he fill his father's shoes or will he not?
One of the most controversial situations ever in World Championship Wrestling centers on Ric Flair and Tatsumi Fujinami.
You know, Flair's got a strong case, but he's not exactly a member of the clergy. It'll be very, very interesting next week.
And we'll see that situation next week. Fans, we'll see you at that time.